What's up, y'all? I said, what's up, y'all? Look at me when I'm talking to you, bro. Nah, I'm just messing with y'all, man. This is Knockout Boxing 86 TV, and we in here. So check this out, bro. Before I get going on today's video, y'all should know what to do by now, man. Be sure to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you're new here, and share the video, bro. If you come through and watch my video, be sure to hit that like button. Put your seatbelt on when you hop in my car. And also comment down below. I want to chop it up with y'all and talk boxing with you, but I can't do that unless you leave a comment. So be sure to comment down below so we can chop it up and talk boxing. And if you want to have me hop on a panel or you want to collaborate with me, reach out to me on my email address at knockoutboxing86@yahoo.com. Again, that's knockoutboxing, the number 8, the number 6, at yahoo.com. But without further ado, let's get it popping and let's get into today's video. And today, we gonna react to our fight predictions. Bro, we had a good week. We only got one fight wrong, bro. Two of the fights didn't happen. So that left us with like a 5-1, 6-1 record, I believe. I'm gonna do the math here in my head while we're breaking it down. But first, let's talk about the Daniel Dubois fight, bro. Daniel Dubois looked good against Bogdan Danu, bro. Knocked his ass out in the second round, bro. Showed good power, showed good skills. And I just knew Bogdan Danu, bro, wasn't gonna be much of a threat to him. I still don't see any improvements in Daniel Dubois' defense. I just don't think Bogdan Danu was able to challenge his defense, was able to see if he still had that hole that he showed in the Joe George fight. I think we'll find out as he continues to move back up in competition. But a good comeback fight for him. Definitely a tune-up fight. He did what he was supposed to do, bro. Got Bogdan Danu up out of there, didn't play with him, beat the shit out of him. So props to Daniel Dubois. We'll see what's next from him. As far as the Floyd Mayweather undercard and the preliminary card, bro, everybody that I thought was shine, bro. Jaleel Hackett won, got that one right. Dorian Khan Jr. won, got that one right. Adrian Benton, he won as well, got that one right. Mikey Scala, bro, that shit didn't even happen because Mikey Scala's opponent is a straight hoe, bro, a straight sucker. By all accounts, the dude that Mikey Scala, I don't know how you say his name. The dude that Scala was supposed to fight, bro, flew home, bro. He flew home like a whole sucker, bro. He need to just quit boxing. He had a 1-1 record coming into this fight, bro. He should never fight again, fam. He should never fight again, bro. You flew home the day of the fight, bro. You ain't want no smoke like that. He spooked you and scared you like that, dog. I believe the dude's name is Adam Ramirez. Somebody correct me if I'm wrong. But Adam Ramirez, whatever your name is, bro, I believe that's your name. I'm going off the top of my head in my car. But shit, you need to quit boxing, bro. You a whole sucker and you need to quit boxing, bro. That's some whole sucker shit, man. Robbing Scala out of his opportunity to perform on a big stage like that, bro. So Mikey Scala didn't even end up fighting, bro. He didn't even end up fighting. Badu Jack beat the shit out of Colina like I thought he would. So we got that one right as well. And then what's the other one, bro? Gene Carlos Torres knocked out his opponent. So we got that one right as well. So we on the roll, bro. We on the roll. And the one I want to talk about most, man, is the one I got wrong, bro. The one I want to talk about most is the one I got wrong. And that's Jerry Hurd, bro. That's Jerry Hurd versus Luis Arias, bro. He got his ass beat, bro. Jerry Hurd showed no improvement, man. And it's what I worry about with him, bro. And that's why he need to quit saying Jermell Charlo name. He need to, I ain't gonna say he need to retire, bro. But we gotta lower our expectations for Jerry Hurd, bro. He get hit too easy, dog. Luis Arias was continuously hitting him with an overhand right from his kneecap, bro. He was throwing the overhand right from his ankle, bro. And Jerry Hurd had no defense for it, bro. And this is what I be saying about some of these boxers, bro. Certain people, the shoulder roll, they need to get the hell away from them, bro. Whoever taught him the shoulder roll and that shit where he put his hand on over his face and try to roll, bro, he's not fast enough. He don't counter good enough for that shit. His reflexes ain't good enough. And quite frankly, bro, his boxing skills ain't good enough to do that shoulder roll shit. You got to be supremely skilled. You gotta have great reflexes, right? And you gotta be able to counterpunch your ass off, bro. That's what the shoulder roll is for you to roll into and use that momentum to be able to throw a uppercut, bro, a counter uppercut. For you to roll and be able to use and go off your back foot and spring forward to your front foot to throw that counter pull counter, bro. Like, that's what that shit is for, bro. And he don't do that shit right at all, bro. Like, he is consistently open for overhand right. And if he was fighting somebody like Jermell Charlo, bro, Jermell Charlo would have put his ass to sleep, bro. Because that's what's wrong when you rely on your athleticism, your strength, and your size, as Jerry Hurd did for the majority of his career, bro. When you rely on that shit, eventually, when you get to the top of the top levels, bro, it's going to be somebody that's just as big, just as strong, just as athletic, but they're going to be done hone their craft. And they're going to have better boxing skills than you. Or in this instance, Luis Arias, he ain't as strong as Jerry Hurd. He ain't as athletic as Jerry Hurd. He ain't as big as Jerry Hurd, which as a result, we got a competitive fight. But he's far more skilled than Jerry Hurd. He's a better inside fighter than Jerry Hurd. He has better defense than Jerry Hurd. He has better fundamentals. And as a result, he landed the cleanest shots. The fight wasn't that close. And we don't need to hear shit else from Jerry Hurd for a while, bro. And I'm really, really disappointed in him. I'm disappointed in Coach K as well because he didn't fix any holes in his game, bro. Jerry Hurd fixed absolutely no holes in this game, bro. His defense is still trash. He still don't box and come forward behind his jab good enough. You know what I mean? If Jerry Hurd is going to be successful at this point in his career on the other side of 30, bro, he needs to make sure he's always in phenomenal shape. He needs to throw punches and bunches. And he has to get out of that shoulder roll shit. He's better off and better served, bro. Just shelling up, using the high guard and walking you down and trying to beat you up and taking a little bit of punches to get in on the inside, bro. That's what he's better served at doing, bro. That's just the bottom line for him, bro. So, you know, disappointed in him, man. Hope that he bounces back from this. But you could tell after the fight, man, how disappointed and how hurt he was to have lost like that, bro. And it's been a precipitous fall from the top, bro. Like, you got to understand, not more than 2 years ago, man, Jerry Hurd was a three-belt unified champion, fam. He was a three-belt unified champion, one fight from being undisputed, and now he's losing to fringe contenders, bro. You know what I'm saying? Decisively at that, bro. Like, I don't want to hear shit about Jerry Hurd getting robbed, fam. I don't. We got to keep it a buck. He did not get robbed, bro. He got his ass whooped. He got his ass whooped, bro. And so overall, man, let's count them up, man. We got Badu Jack right. We got Adrian Benton right. We got Dorian Khan right. We got Jaleel Hackett right. You feel me? We got John Carlos Torres right. And we got Daniel Dubois right. That's six right. You know what I mean? No, that's seven right. No, that's six right and one wrong. So we went 6-1, bro. The other two fights, the Mikey Scala fight and the Vidal Riley fight, those fights didn't happen, bro. Those two fights didn't happen. So we got a no contest on them. But we went 6-1 this week, bro. We bounced back. So that brings our overall record. We was 42-10 going into the weekend. Now we 48-11, bro. That's what I'm talking about. Your boy is back. Your boy is back on his predictions. I'm back on my prediction king shit. I'm the predictor of the predictions that's doing the predicting when the predictions need to be predicted at the right predicted time, bro. That's how I'm coming. But now let's talk about the event a little bit. Then I'll get y'all out of here, bro. Overall, the event to me, and I'm talking about Floyd Mayweather's card, bro, versus Logan Powell. I purposefully did not do a Chad Johnson, Ocho Cinco prediction. I didn't do a Floyd Mayweather-Logan Powell prediction because that ain't what I'm about on this channel, bro. I don't really like to rock with that shit. I'm all about boxing, bro, and bringing boxing to the forefront. And I don't have no problem with people getting their money, getting their bread, bro. I don't. Get your money however you can get your money, as long as it ain't no illegal shit, as long as it don't mess with me and mine. I don't really care, bro. I really don't care. But at the same time, I want to promote what's good for boxing. And to me, the Floyd Mayweather-Logan Powell whole event was a fiasco. First of all, they had people slipping all over the ring. Damn near could have tore their ACL up or broke their ankle or some shit because they had the shit outside and it was raining, bro. And some rain came into the damn ring a couple of times, bro. And they had to pause the fight, put the fight on timeout. It was the Jerry Hurd Arias fight, as a matter of fact. Had to put the fight in timeout. Had to wipe the goddamn canvas down and shit, bro. Just bad, bro. Like, it wasn't really, you know what I mean, like a smooth event. Then you go from that to the Badu Jack situation where you got a fighter in Jean Pascal that messed the event up, testing positive, because that was the most legitimate, you know what I'm saying, fight on the card, bro. It was for a world championship, and Jean Pascal fucked it up. He messed that shit all the way up. And so that took some luster off the event, bro. Made the shit kind of like, you know what I'm saying? Unless you a diehard fan like me, like, you got people watching, you know, fringe contenders and prospects and shit, and then a side show, you know what I mean? It just, like, it ain't really, it wasn't worth it, bro. I paid $50 for that shit, and you got to think, you got Chad Johnson, you know what I'm saying? That shit ain't a real fight. Then you got Jerry Hurd versus Luis Arias, by far the most entertaining fight. But we got fringe contenders versus, you know, what's turning out to be almost close to a has-been in Jerry Hurd. Then you got the championship fight that was supposed to be the co-main event, where it was supposed to be Badu Jack versus Jean Pascal, the most exciting fight on the card. That shit get downgraded to Badu Jack versus Dervin Corlina, bro, out of Venezuela, who looked overmatched and got his ass knocked out and was holding on the whole damn fight. Just made it very unentertaining and very, like, hard to swallow the fact that you paid $50 for this shit. You know what I mean? And then the main event, bro. Floyd Mayweather, Logan Paul, bro. This is the shit that I don't like. Floyd Mayweather is 44 years old. You feel what I'm saying? He's a legend in the game, obviously. He is who he is. His legacy and his resume can't be tarnished. But you got people that are waking up today on this Monday morning, bro, that's bashing Floyd, talking about how, you know, Logan Paul won and shit. And it just gives people room to do that shit when they hate you like that. And again, get your money, bro. But at the very least, like, it should have been an understanding that Logan Paul just can't hug you the whole fight, bro. And that's what it was, fam. They was in a grappling contest damn near the whole fight. Damn near the whole fight. You know what I mean? And at the end of the day, bro, that ain't what people pay to see, dog. Like, if you're going to pay for a boxing exhibition, give us some boxing, homie. Like, y'all actually fight. Now, it ain't Floyd's fault. You know what I mean? He was trying to box. He ain't like Logan Paul holding him and shit. But you got to expect that shit when you fighting somebody that's a novice and you catch him with one of them hooks that he caught his ass with. Motherfucker going to start holding you, especially he outweigh you by 40 pounds. He physically stronger than you. He going to hold you the whole damn fight. And then you got his brother. You know what I'm saying? Him and his brother. Now, they're acting like they beat you, bro. So you in a lose-lose situation for Floyd. So, I mean, I guess, you know, good money, bro. Easy money. So get your bread. But I just feel like, bro, he need to shine more light on his younger prospects, bro. Put together a card where it's just your fighters or some shit, bro. Do some shit like that, bro. But at the end of the day, the event as a whole, man, it wasn't really nothing that, you know what I mean, that stuck home with me. Nothing that I'm just excited to come on here and talk to y'all about, bro. And that just kind of moved the needle, bro. I'm glad that this week we got Shakur Stevenson coming up, bro. Let's get back to some real shit. Let's get back to some real shit, some real boxing, bro. You know what I mean? But overall, I'm happy because my prediction recommend, I struck again on y'all ass, bro. I'm back. We had a bad week last week. I know a lot of y'all was out on your boy. A lot of y'all like, man, what are you doing, bro? Knockout don't know what he's talking about. He went 2-3. Nah, bro. We back up. We 6-1 this week, bro. 48-11 overall, bro. 48-11 prediction record, bro. Go check the catalog. Y'all know how I do, bro. Y'all know what it is with me, man. We the prediction king, bro. We the predictors of the predicting that's doing the predicting when the predicting needs to be predicted, bro. That's how we coming. But anyway, bro, y'all let me know what y'all thought of this weekend. Overall for me, you know what I mean? Wasn't really excited about it. I gotta buy the shit because I support boxing wholeheartedly and I bring y'all content and shit. And if I'm gonna ask y'all to buy the shit, if I'm gonna ask y'all to support boxing, I gotta support it, bro. And that's just what it is, man. You know what I mean? I tried to find a stream, couldn't find it. Be 100% real with y'all. And now I was like, ah, shit. I got to cover the shit. Let me go ahead and fucking buy it. I don't want to buy it, but I got to buy it. So I bought it. And now I got to talk to y'all about it. The only thing I'm happy about is my prediction record, bro. That's it. That's all I got for y'all, bro. But y'all let me know what y'all think, man. Comment down below. Be sure to hit the like button. Subscribe to the channel. Share the video. Put your seatbelt on when you hop in my car. And if you want me on the panel or you want to collaborate with me, you should know the email address by now, bro. KnockoutBoxing86@yahoo.com. I appreciate everybody watching. Y'all enjoy the rest of your day. And with that, we out here. Peace.